right, you know. Because we want to get to the tourists, and hopefully we want to get to the kids and say, hey people, you know, take a look at this.
Yeah. Are you going to do it again, Dave, in the near future?
Yeah. I mean, the main purpose of that night was to get the film.
Well, you know, because it wasn't quite full, it left room for the camera crew.
Oh, they were over the moon.
Because the stage wasn't raised for the singers, so if it had been heaving, it would have been very difficult for them to film, wouldn't it,
They were over the moon, because they'd done some live filming at one or two other venues, including the Casbah, and they just couldn't get the footage, you know, because the Casbah was chock-a-block.
Yeah, so it worked out well.
Well, that's funny, that's the point, that, Dave. I was looking at YouTube and the Casbah, and the best band was on.
Yeah.
The best fest, that's what it was, yeah, with Earl Preston and the TTs and the Pete Best Band.
Yeah.
And there's a close-up of Pete Best playing the drums, and it was really good. So if anybody's got any questions as, do they think Pete Best was better than Ringo, Ringo better than Pete Best, was there anything wrong with Pete Best's timing? All the questions are answered on YouTube. At the Best Fest at the Casbah, if you want to look on that, answer a lot of questions to a lot of people as to say whether Pete was inadequate, and I was just so thrilled to see it on there, you know. It was absolutely great.
Dave, while we've got you on, what do you have to type in to look at YouTube of the Pan Am, because Alan is saying it is on YouTube, so what would you type in?
If you type in Liverpool Beat on YouTube, or you can go onto the Liverpool site, and there's some videos up there already, and you can watch them on Liverpool Beat, or you can click the YouTube video and it'll take you through to the YouTube channel. So it's liverpoolbeat.com.
Liverpoolbeat.com, right.
Yeah.
Right, excellent.
Okay.
But the venue wanted to rebook it. I mean, they were absolutely stunned at the show that we put on. And do you want me to give you another world exclusive?
Paul McCartney's going to be there.
I'm not supposed to say this, but I can't resist. it looks as if there's going to be a follow-up film called Get Back to Hamburg, and Gary Popper's looking for some of the original musicians to go on a sort of magical mystery tour.
Well, Alan's the man, isn't he? Because he was there. Yeah, he was the man.
Yeah.
And he's got to pay expenses.
Mine God.
I was there, Dave.
I was there as well.
1965.
I was there as well, Dave. I was there. I played bass with the Silver Beetles for a while. Yeah.
So if it comes off, you'll be the first to hear. And then, obviously, you know, we'll be looking for some of the original guys to gather around.
Oh, I'd be thrilled to do it.
Oh, the other thing he's going to do, which might
shut
be...
Shut up, you. Sorry, that was Alan.
But, oh, by the way, Dave, something else that I heard may be happening.
Yeah.
John Lennon's, I think it was the anniversary of John Lennon's death, is it, in December?
Yeah.
Recreating the photograph that Astor Kircher took on the steps at St. George's Hall.
Was it Astor that did the photo?
Yeah, I was on it.
Well,
the Black Knights, we were at the front, because our manager said, get there early, get at the front. I remember, I'd say, just a little story, we were out of town, we come in, and all the vans, you know, the bands had vans with lipstick,
yeah.
I Love Allan Schroeder written on the side of lipstick.
Written by Allan Schroeder.
And as we were on the car park, all the bands were coming down in their vans along Lime Street, and our manager looked out, he said, oh, here's the Cubas, you know, and the van went by with the Cubas in it, I Love You and all that, and all the rest of it on. And then another one come with the Pathfinders, oh, I Love the Pathfinders, and then the next thing, a cleaners van coming around the corner, and our manager said, oh, here's the Cleaners.
What a great band they were.
They were the Cleaners, yeah.
What a band, yeah.
So we were all paid a pound,
yeah.
And I got at the front, and on the right, I don't know how many you'd get now, but on the right hand side was the Motives, which is Derek Green from the Motives, you know, Derek.
Yeah.
Ian Howe.
Ian Howe was there.
Yeah.
Ian sent me the photograph. I put it on Liverpool Beat. It's up there now if anybody wants to have a look at it.
And the other guy, the guitarist with the Jaywalkers.
Charlie was there from the Crying Shames. He was there.
Was he on there?
Yeah.
Oh, was he?
And if you have a look at the photograph on the site, see if you can spot Rory Storm.
Oh, yeah, I remember Rory being there. I thought we shouldn't have been there because the big names like the Searchers and the Swinging Blue Jeans and the Mersey Beats had all flown the nest.
Yeah.
And put poor old Rory was left behind, because that was like the second era of bands, actually.
That's
it was
right.
Like I was with Cliff Robertson and Rockers at first, and Derek Green and them was with the Delrinas, but now some had gone to Hamburg, some recording, and some broke up, and other bands had been, like the Cubas and the Black Knights and the Motifs and stuff, you know. So Rory shouldn't have been there, really. He should have been off on tour, you know, like the rest, really.
You know who's organising the photos, aren't you?
Somebody, well, a name was mentioned to him.
Tony Bolland, and Tony used to run a music shop called The Plug-In. Do you remember The Plug-In?
Yeah,
it
yeah.
was part of Hesse's
yeah.
empire.
Yeah.
So it's Tony, and I think Tony's actually written a book as well. Organising it. Yeah. Obviously, it'll be in the book, you know.
Yeah. Oh, that was Acid Case, yeah, because she had a big set of step ladders. She was on to take the photograph, you know.
So you going to be there?
Me? Well, I'm hoping to be at the front where I was on the original one. I actually did recreate.
You need a wide angle lens for his head.
I did actually recreate the photograph myself in the at Woodside in Birkenhead. Farron's on it. Oh no, he's not. Mushy's on it.
There's
quite a few on that one. But if you were to try to get the original guys, I think you'd have a problem.
Keith,
I would like my front place there, Dave. Yeah.
Keith was there. Keith Hubbard and Ricky Gleason.
Oh, were they?
Yeah, they were there. I phoned Keith tonight, and I said, "Are you going?" And he said, "Yeah, of course, I've got to go." I said, "You taking a guitar?" He says, "I think I've got a cheap one somewhere."
Yeah, oh, yeah.
How times have changed, you know.
Okay, Dave, thanks very much for the chat.
Good luck
with the Mathew Street Band. We'll speak to you again.
Well, thanks a lot, and thanks to Colin for a great song. Let's hope...
Shall I sing a bit of it now?
Why don't you play it?
God, I've forgotten the words. Sorry, carry on. I'll forget
it. Okay, forgot the words. Okay, Dave, thanks very much.
Cheers.
And we'll speak to you again.
Bye, Dave. Thanks.
This is another one for Alvira from last week. Sorry, Alvira. Loving you. I've left her at home. But I hope you do like this.
Love me sweet. Never let me go. You have made my life complete, and I love you so. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will. Love me tender, love me long, take me to your heart. For it's there that I belong, and will never part.